Well, ladies and gentlemen, the big question here is that a hardened criminal who faces TADA, UAPA charges have been leveled against him, and he was roaming freely. Ladies and gentlemen, joining us tonight from the Aam Aadmi Party, Siddharth Sharma, from the BJP, R.P. Singh, Ramesh Sabharwal from the Congress joining us. Siddharth Sharma, I want to start with you first. You have a hardened criminal, multiple charges, comes back from Pakistan, out on bail, roams freely. Today, your police says that a major incident was averted because 170 policemen in plain clothes were inside Golden Temple. But Mr. Sharma, let me first begin by asking you, for the first time, gunshots were fired after Operation Blue Star. Today, heads should be rolling.
Well, Shravan, when an attempt to crime is clearly foiled in place of commending it when debunked myths are floated, it means there is a clear attempt to malign the good name of Punjab, and that's why the Punjab Chief Minister has ordered an inquiry of highest order to uncover this conspiracy. Now, as your visuals are already showing, the fact that a weapon-wielding assailant was apprehended by an unarmed police, Punjab police personnel, before committing a crime itself shows how agile, well-trained and professional Punjab police is. Now, let me put this into context. Let us bunk a few myths today.
The but he entered, showing, you say that also those same very visuals, Mr. Sharma, shows that you have a hardened criminal entering the Golden Temple, walking freely, brandishing a 9mm pistol, and then you are saying that perhaps the 170 policemen were agile?
Yes, not just 150 policemen, the entire police system of Punjab is agile, and that's why I said, let me put this into context. Let us debunk a few myths today. The data I am showing is not my data, it's the Modi Sarkar's National Crime Record Bureau data. Any one of Republic Channel's viewers can find it online. It reflects Punjab crime rate as one and a half times lower than India's crime rate and five times lower than Delhi's crime rate. Now, both are ruled by BJP, one within miles of India's Home Minister's own residence. Can the BJP say the same thing about an intelligence failure when an MLA is shot and killed in Maharashtra, or when the BJP, or when in Delhi there is triple murders happening just today 8 kilometers from the Home Minister's house? How come Punjab's crime rate is lower than India's crime rate and Delhi's crime rate? The moot question is that. The simple question...
Sardar R.P. Singh, I'll get the opening remarks also. You've heard what Siddharth Sharma of the Aam Aadmi Party has to say. The counter to it, Mr. Sharma, I'll come to it in a short while from now, but let's have the opening remarks from all sides. Sardar R.P. Singh, Aam Aadmi Party says that you have no moral right to raise any questions as far as law and order is concerned, but look at what is happening in the national capital. There's a murder that has been reported. The fact that just a few days back, the former Chief Minister of Delhi, Arvind Kejriwal, says a rape has taken place. There was nothing that was done. So it has been reduced to my law and order situation tackling is better than yours.
Well, who does the rape? MLAs from the party, all women at home, ration cut and rape. It's on record. Who are the people who are leaving banks and who are hobnobbing with the gangsters? Huh? Naresh Balia was talking to gangsters that to go and call up this person and I'll do the Marwari in between. So, who is involved? But let's talk about Punjab. They are just thumping about that they're one of the sub-inspector or assistant sub-inspector could nab the assailant. But the man was roaming free on the streets of Amritsar, and then has visited Amritsar Golden Temple twice in the last 2 days to the Reiki. And then police knew his background. And even then, police didn't nab him.
I'll come to that.
Another second. And also, why this is happening in Punjab today, the Khalistanis or the radicals and the gangsters have come together to disturb the peace of Punjab. I'll give you one example and I'll finish with that, my opening remark. There's a speaker named Sadwan Saab. He has just recently met Harjit Singh Bajwa. Recently, a year back, sorry. Harjit Singh Bajwa. He went to Canada the party or the get-together was hosted by Harjit Singh Bajwa. Now, who is Harjit Singh Bajwa? A known stamped Khalistani. Raghav Chatterjee was in London. He only one picture we have seen in London of Raghav Chatterjee with Preet Gill. Now, Preet Gill is an open supporter of Khalistanis.
I just don't want to reduce this by simply, you know, looking at it from the law and order perspective only. But the fact of the matter that this is an internal security threat too. Mr. Ramesh Sabharwal, from the Congress party's point of view, we have seen when the Congress was also in power in the state of Punjab, the same footsie that you've essentially played with the Khalistani sympathizers is something that has been the biggest cause of concern.
Good evening. We condemn this kind of crime, you know, which the gentleman has done today. And Mr. Badal is lucky that, by the grace of God, he is saved, you know. But this is not a good sign of any state or any country where the law and order situation goes out of the hand. I was listening to both of them. In Delhi, some problems are going on every day. In Punjab also, the ex-deputy chief minister of Punjab, he has been saved by the Punjab police. He's so lucky, you know. So this is very serious matters, you know, concerning the security of the common man, concerning the security of our leaders who sacrifice their lives for the country.
No, but it's turning
so
out
hard work.
No, it's turning out to be the biggest cause of concern. I'll tell you why. I'll tell you why it's becoming a bigger cause of concern. And Mr. Sharma, the Aam Aadmi Party ought to take this very seriously. And I'm telling you this not just because of the incident that has happened today. Your own leaders, back in 2015, your own leader, Dharamveer Gandhi, had basically said that it's a dangerous game that you are playing. Why? Let me list this out. Supporting radical Sikhs for the premature release of militants. Your own person, Dharamveer Gandhi, pointed out saying that you're playing a dangerous game. Then you have your own leader, who's in charge of the state of Punjab, seen intermingling with the Khalistani sympathizers when they've gone abroad. And the allegation that sticks to you is the fact that perhaps you are soft on those who are seen as Khalistani sympathizers.
Well, Shravan, there are allegations, and allegations can be conjectures. When you say there is some foreign national or some foreign entity is allegating something on Aam Aadmi Party, then by that same logic, a foreign government agency called the United States Justice Department has allegated something against India's top corporate honcho. So that doesn't make it true. So the fact of the matter is, I've shown...
It's your own leader who's saying this. I'm not saying this. Your own leader has said this back in 2015.
Nobody from Aam Aadmi Party has hobnobbed with any anti-national or anti-social elements. And the proof here is that Punjab's delicate yet successful handling of the Amritpal Singh incident is itself a certificate, isn't it, of how...
That's for Mr. Sabharwal to say. That's for Mr. Sabharwal to say also, because when they were in power, what really happened with Amritpal Singh?
So, Aam Aadmi Party ensured that Amritpal Singh incident was policed and done so discreetly.
I think Sardar R.P. Singh is showing you something.
And it did not bother the common people, didn't it?
Sardar R.P. Singh is showing you something, Siddharth Sharma.
No, theek hai.
This is the R.P. Singh of their speaker.
Sir, there are...
Siddharth Sharma and Sardar R.P. Singh together.
Sir, this is a picture of the speaker with Harjit Singh Bajwa. Stamped Khalistani.
And sir, day before yesterday when I
was... Let's have them together.
In Delhi, na?
Sardar R.P. Singh and Siddharth Sharma together.
Who attacked Mr. Arvind Kejriwal turned out to be a BJP member. So is BJP saying that BJP is full of coons? I don't know what BJP is trying to make out. The moot point I'm trying to make, Shravan. The
moot point I'm trying to make, Shravan.
Okay, one by one. Siddharth Sharma. Okay, can we have it a little focused here?
And justice are the most important and foremost duty of any government. Whatever government is there in any state or nation, The foremost duty of any government is to ensure security and justice to all. That is why Aam Aadmi Party Punjab has added 8,000 new policemen to its force.
Okay, but Siddharth Sharma, if that's the case, let's also look at the facts here. I understand political leaders want to perhaps peddle some rhetoric here, but Siddharth Sharma, if I want to bring it, make it much more focused, let me just tell you this. Why again and again this allegation is sticking to you? Just about a few months back in September, you've had a US-based Khalistani gangster, Harpreet Singh, claiming responsibility for an explosion that took place in Sector 10 in Chandigarh that targeted the retired superintendent of police, Jas Kirat Singh Chahal. One more incident that has taken place after you've come to power. Then you have had incidents that have actually taken place, protests that have taken place, sympathizers, Khalistani sympathizers have been spotted, but no action was taken. Today you have a Khalistani terrorist who started the Khalistan National Army, came back in 1984, released on bail, allowed to roam freely. Your police says there was no intelligence failure. Now you tell me, these are facts that I've laid out for you. How do you really counter this?
Yeah, Shravan, when you say some foreign, I've already repeated it.
No, I'm not saying foreign. These are facts. I just listed out for you the incidents where there has been a direct Khalistan link while you are in power. So these are not conjectures.
You yourself quoted about some foreign nationals allegating something about Aam Aadmi Party. Now the moot point is if foreign nationals.
No, Mr. Sharma, you are again missing out. I am talking. I just listed out something else.
Is to be taken for what it is worth. Then the foreign governments of India have been.
Mr. Sharma, again you are missing out. I have not quoted. I have not. Okay, Mr. Sharma. Mr. Sharma.
Does that hold good? They are saying something about foreign.
No, Mr. Sharma. Like why don't you hear me out? Siddharth Sharma, why don't you hear me out? That is not what I'm arguing here. That is not what I'm arguing here.
Is that Punjab's crime rate
but
today?
Mr. Siddharth Sharma, please understand. Calm down and listen to me once, and then let's have the others to also respond.
And I am not
going by certain foreign individuals making allegations against your government. I am simply listing out incidents. Mr. Sharma, please hear my question. I am not referring to any allegation leveled by a foreign individual, foreign institution. I am simply listing out incidents that have taken place when you have come to power, after you have come to power, and there is a direct Khalistani link that has emerged. That is what I have listed out for you.
So didn't I answer your question when I said that Punjab's delicate yet successful handling of the Amritpal incident, isn't it certificate enough of Aam Aadmi Party Punjab's handling of this incident very discreetly, delicately, ensuring that the crime is neutralized, yet the people of Punjab
Sardar,
are not put into,
Sardar RP Singh, put into any Amritpal kind of, Singh.
Difficulty. That's the answer.
Okay.
Punjab.
Okay, let me take this to... Okay. Okay, if that's your answer, if that's your counter to this... Okay, Siddharth Sharma, that's your counter. You are saying that we have effectively handled the threat coming in from Amritpal Singh. Sardar RP Singh, the question comes to you also. The fact of the matter is this. For a very long time, Amritpal Singh was actually allowed to run amok in Punjab. Till the time you've had the center really coming into the picture. So somewhere down the line, has the centre also taken this very lightly, the K-terror emanating from Punjab and also perhaps outside India now?
Now, let me expose them further. I just showed you the picture of Sandwan with Harjit Singh Bajwa. Now, this is the second picture, if I can show you. Yeah, here. This is the only picture Raghav Chetta posted when he was abroad with Preet Gill. Who is a known supporter of Khalistanis. Now, I'll show you a third picture. This is a Khalistani parade in Amritsar. Every year after they have come, it never used to happen earlier. It's happening year after they have come. The Khalistanis take out parade and then under the nose of the police. So, problem is, there's a police protection because of the political shielding, and then because probably it's a repay back time also, could be, I don't know, because they have, there are messages from Patwan Spannu, Satwa, just, who says that we have paid some huge amount to Aam Aadmi Party to win elections. So that could be the reason that they are soft. That's why RPG attack happened at a police station. That's why the people in Ludhiana, Jalandhar, Amritsar gets calls for extortion. The businessmen get calls from extortion, and from both radicals and from gangster, both put together. So there's a new nexus which has built during their time. People have been shot dead. Two Hindu leaders were shot dead. A sinter was shot dead. A player was shot dead.
In Delhi, everyone is getting, every businessman is getting
a ransom. I don't want to get it. I understand,
Is the BJP saying
Siddharth Sharma, please understand one thing. I understand it's come. It's perhaps easier and comfortable to basically talk about other states. I understand, Siddharth Sharma, that it is easier to talk about the other states right now. But there is a larger cause of concern here. And let's not trivialize by simply saying that, look at the law and order situation in Uttar Pradesh. Let's look at the law and order situation in West Bengal. Then we should look into what's happening in Kerala. Ramesh Sabharwal. Gentlemen, 1 minute. Can I also get it? Ramesh Sabharwal. It is not just about the Aam Aadmi Party and the BJP here. Siddharth Sharma, I'll come back to you. Siddharth Sharma, 1 minute. Allow Ramesh ji also to come in. Ramesh ji. Charanjit Singh Channi, the former Punjab Chief Minister, can I take this with you? Former Punjab Chief Minister Charanjit Singh Channi, when he was asked about supporting Amritpal Singh, this is what he said. They speak about emergency every day, but what about the undeclared emergency in the country today? This too is an emergency that a man was elected as an MP by 20 lakh people in Punjab is behind bars under the NSA. He is unable to present the views of the people of his constituency here. This too is an emergency. Now, this is the former Punjab Chief Minister talking about Amritpal Singh. Ladies and gentlemen, if this is how we are going to deal with the Khalistani threat emanating Ramesh Sabharwal, then who's going to take anyone seriously here?
My submission is that, there are four issues for the society also. Sikh religion, Golden Temple is the most religious place for the Sikh religion. The incident took place outside the Golden Temple, number one. Number two, the sevak who was punished by the Gurdwara committee, he was shot, they tried to shoot him. Akal Takht. My submission is that where the society we are moving, I feel that the Sikh religion is such a committed religion for the society, and the incidents which are taking place in our society, we should be concerned more about that. Why this is happened outside Gurdwara, and that to the ex-chief minister, Mr. Badal. These are serious concerns for all of us. Where we are going. Where the country is lacking, what wrong we are doing, what more we are politicalizing. So Khalistani movement has to condemn, and we have sacrificed Indraji for that. So my submission is that we should be concerned more that these kinds of incidents must not take place anywhere in the country, most probably outside the religious places at least. We should respect the God. I don't know what kind of Sikh he was. Who started shooting outside the Gurdwara? I can't see where our society is moving, which direction we are moving.
Okay. One last comment: we being the leaders of any political party. It is undoubtedly.
We being the leaders of any political
undoubtedly
party.
Extremely. Go ahead, Mr. Sabharwal. Make your comment.
We are responsible. We are all responsible for this. We all sit together and we should resolve all these issues for the sake of the country, for the sake of the religion at least. हम धर्म को नहीं छोड़ रहे, धर्म के गुरुद्वारों के बाहर ऐसी हरकतें करते हैं, लानत है हमारे संस्कारों के ऊपर, लानत है हमारे फ्रीडम फाइटर्स के ऊपर, जिन्होंने इस कंट्री का और हमारे को गुरु नानक जी की जो प्रीचिंग्स है, सर्वदा पला, हम उसको खोखला कर रहे हैं। ये बहुत गलत इंसिडेंट्स है। ऐसे इंसिडेंट्स के लिए तमाम पॉलिटिकल पार्टी को, आई अपील टू केजरीवाल, आई अपील टू पंजाब सीएम, ऑल पॉलिटिकल पार्टीज ऑफ पंजाब शुड सिट टुगेदर, द बीजेपी, कांग्रेस एंड आप पार्टी, वी शुड यूनाइट फॉर द सोसाइटी।
सिद्धार्थ शर्मा, collapsing law and order is the allegation that still sticks to you, and the fact of the matter is this, that if stringent measures are not taken, then perhaps this is going to go down the drain. And Ramesh Sabharwal is right to say that, you know, everyone is equally responsible. The Congress party is responsible for what happened. Now look at what, how you are basically responding to it by simply saying that, look here, we have effectively arrested the person, is not good enough. And I've listed out few reasons why this argument is not good enough.
Yeah, I think this argument is not at all good enough, that there are triple murders happening in Delhi. Sitting MLA is killed in Maharashtra where BJP is in power. Now, Punjab crime rate, if it is lower than the rest of India and Delhi, it means that Punjab government has been doing something right. Punjab has the most courageous and hardworking people. Highest farming and highest in armed forces are its proof. Now, when an attempt to crime is clearly foiled and...
One final word.
The debunked myths are floated. That essentially means that there is a conspiracy by some ecosystem, which the chief minister...
One final word. Sardar R.P. Singh, on an issue like this, can it go beyond partisan politics? Can all the parties come together? Because Khalistani threat is not only restricted to the Aam Aadmi Party, but it is for the entire nation.
First, let me also salute to that ASI, Jasbir Singh, who went ahead and then grabbed that person. I mean, let's be fair on this. But let's understand, who is shielding Khalistanis? Who is helping Khalistanis? Amritpal Singh and Rahul Gandhi speak the same language, that we are not the one nation. And Sabharwal Sahib, I'm sending you this book for reading. This is the book on Khalistan conspiracy. And you must read book by G.P.S. Sidhu, who was son-in-law of Soren Singh. He'll let you know how Mrs. Gandhi conspired the Khalistani conspiracy. And how did she build up the complete thing and painted the most nationalist community as anti-national for her vote bank.
Okay. Thank you very much, Sardar R.P. Singh, Ramesh Sabharwal and Siddharth Sharma for joining us on Debate No. 1.